Hello and welcome to iPatientCare iWebcast. This is Harsh, and today I have my colleague and billing expert, Mr. Tejas Vyas, who has been enhancing revenues of various practices who have been associated with iPatientCare. And today we will be discussing about the new Medicare cards which have been introduced by CMS. So Tejas, what are the new Medicare cards and why have they been introduced by CMS?
Well, Harish, it's a good thing that we are trying to project this particular hot topic right now, which is actually moving across in the market. It has been a long thought of for the CMS for introducing this new Medicare card, and especially now it is the right time since a lot of theft and fraudulent situations are going across with this new Medicare. With the existing Medicare cards. That's been utilized by the patients. The existing Medicare cards, basically, the healthcare claim identification number, is basically nothing but a social security number, which is actually causing a lot of trouble for the senior age peoples, where they have been threatened, by various scammers and hackers. And this was the reason why Medicare thought that it's the right moment, while a new technology boostings and the new security measures under the HITECH and HIPAA clauses that have been introduced. So that is the first foremost reason of why this has been introduced with the new Medicare cards.
Okay. So what is your take? How would it affect the practices, their operations, their billing?
Well, let me just give you a slight insight on what exactly the new Medicare card would be. As I said, it's going to replace the social security number, what's indicated as their claim numbers or the HCL number. So now the new Medicare cards, which will be starting to roll down from the next financial year, and it will continue in the transition till April 2019. Which means that they have almost around 21 months of the transition period. Now, the number what you would get on the Medicare card would be an 11-digit character combinations of the number, basically, that would be represented on the card. And it is a non-intelligent card, which means that there is no significant, a pattern of that card which would represent that, okay, this is an SSN number or this is an identity of a patient. So it's a non-intelligent number of 11 digits or combinations of alphanumeric combinations. There are certain alphabets which have been omitted by the CMS because those alphabets are something which has been utilized by other insurance carriers which are floating in the market, so that those reservations are there. Now, when we coming to the point what you said as to what's going to be the impact of the practice. Now, it's going to be a challenge for the practices because it's going to start from the next year, and then your claim submission process, or you talk about the eligibility verification, or you talk about the coordination of benefit exchange between the two insurance companies. So it's going to be a big challenge time. How to verify this information. Now, are you going to submit your claims with the old, the Medicare identity number, or you are going to submit it by the new Medicare identity number? Whether the records would be updated across all the systems or not. So those are the challenges which the practice would be encountering during this transition phase. No doubt that CMS has been saying that they are going to come up with tools, secure tools, which will help them identify the new Medicare card numbers and make their life process easier. But nevertheless, you can understand that almost around 68 millions of Medicare insured patients are there. When volume speaks, always there are chances of hurdles that are bound to happen. So this is where, it's an impact that's going to happen to practice and how they should be cautious on, keeping themselves updated.
Okay, so Tejas, you said about hurdles, practices mm-hmm. would face some kind of hurdle. So how can those practices who are facing this kind of problems can
eliminate or at least make some, you know, their way around and come up with a solution?
Well, since I have been with, associated with the different departments and the process within the iPatientCare and have been helping out the clients, what I would say is that, you know, the practice should be more focused and oriented towards the patient, the patient treatment part of it rather than focusing on those areas. iPatientCare would be able to extend our services and render the service in terms of, you know, ensuring that, you know, you have the right card information and, or basically we would be able to go ahead and help them out in taking the judgment call whether you should be actually doing the claim submissions with your old number or the new number and ensuring that how the coordination of benefits can get updated into the patient's various insurances they have it on record. So this is something very easier and a helping hand that can be extended to iPatientCare for our users. Otherwise, as such, as I said, it's a long process and it's a never-ending, though we have a stipulated time of 21 months. Within this 21 months, we can help them slowly and steadily in gradual way, uplifting them into the transition process. That's how we can actually help them out with that.
Okay. Thank you, Tejas, for enlightening our viewers on this particular topic, the new Medicare cards that have been introduced by CMS. And viewers, please watch out for some more insightful sessions. We will be coming back